Welcome learners to Sarthak Education Channel. This is Sini Patel Digital Room to learn about Android Studio. Today we are going to learn how to run our project. Let us begin with the basic terms ADB. Before that, I want to show you where ADB will be used. So I am going to click start button and press on Android Studio option. It will taking a time to start your Android Studio. As I already discussed, depends on system configurations, it may take time to start your Android Studio. So friends, how to open Android Studio? Start menu and there is Android Studio options. But sometimes if you want to set your shortcut on startup or start menu, just right click and pin to taskbar, and that will be paste your icon on taskbar. So there is no need to next time go through with start and then Android Studio. Instead of that, you can just click here and it will be open for you Android Studio. Here the last step was run your project. Just click on it and it will be initialize ADB. Dear friends, here I am going to explain what is ADB. So what is ADB? ADB stands for Android Debug Bridge. What is the purpose of an ADB? It is a tool that is used for communication with device. It is a client server based program. It has main three components. One, client, which is sending some commands. Daemon, that is also called ADBD, runs command on device as background process. And third one, that is called server, which manage your communication between client and daemon as a background process. ADB also provide some facilities like device actions such as installing, debugging and Unix shell. Let's move to the Android Studio. Here I have one virtual device, and through these options we can create a new virtual device. If you don't want to follow the same procedure every time, just tick and it will take as these last options as your default options for running your Android project. Right now I am untick and going to click a new virtual device. So my friend, we have a main category, that is TV, phone, Wear OS and tablets. So basis on the click of options, the picture will be shown here. When you click on phone, it will look like phone. When you create Wear OS, it will be look like Wear, and it will be tablet. So I am going to click on phone. There is a name of phone. There is a Play Store options. The size of mobiles or phone is given. Resolution is also given. Even density is also given. So out of these configurations, you may use any kind of devices. Right now, I am follow with Pixel 2. Just click here. So friend, what is the process of these options? It will try to select system image. What is meaning image? Here, My operating system for that virtual device is Oreo. The level of that operating system API is 26. The operating version is 8.0. Who is the developer? Google itself. And the system image for Intel machine, so it is called x86. So why I am selling API level 26, and how we can understand or how we want to distribute maximum our applications to end users. So here you can see here API level distribution charts. Our selection was 8.0 Oreo. So the API level is 26. The version of operating system is 8.0 and name of operating system is Oreo. So what is a contributions or distributions level at the end user? That is 6.0 only. Yes friends, if I am going to select upper versions or API lower versions, that means the distributions level will be increased. If I am going to select newer versions or latest versions, the distributions will be decreased. So if I want to work with API 19, that means you will cover up to 95.3% users from the different area. So what are the benefits of Oreo? Why we are selecting Oreo as a operating system for our virtual device? And these are the benefits: at system level benefits, user level benefits, media level benefits, wireless and connectivity options, security and privacy options. I'm going to click. So are you understand what is Oreo, what is API levels 26, why we used x86, and what is Android 8.0? Yes friends, we will discuss much more later on. So I'm going to click next button. So NAMF AVD is already, the name of AVD is already taken from Android Studio. So this is good thing for us. There is no need to give any name, but if you want to provide name, you may give your username also. This is called device, or this is called operating system. So this device going to load with Oreo operating system. What is the orientations? This is called orientations or portrait mode. And if you want to set by default your orientation for your application, that is landscape mode, you can set. But right now we are working with default settings. If you want to see something more regarding to advanced settings, click here. So it will provide different kinds of options like this. If you want to set camera, front side, back side. If you want to set network speed, you can set here. If you want to even set up boot, cold boot and quick boot, then you may set here. And even if you want to setting for RAM, virtual memory, internal storage, SD card and so. If you want to set enable keyboard, you may set here. Otherwise, you may go through a default settings that is available by your Android Studio. So I am going to finish now. So what happened? I had already one virtual device and I am going to create a new virtual device. So I have two different or same configurations virtual device. So before that, I want to show you how a virtual device needs. So let us continue with our